What's up, YouTube? Today is February 19th, 2020. This is the first video on my channel. It's gonna be a basic mic test and stuff. I got my helmet set up a while back, but it's been so rainy I haven't got a chance to actually use it. It's literally rained every day that I've been off. So today's the first day that it's not raining. And I'm gonna see if we can get a little video in and test the microphone and see how that works, and we'll go from there. We got all the dogs out here playing. Florence is so tough. She's so tough. All right, well, here she is. It's probably about 58 degrees out here, I think is what it said. So it's not freezing, but it's definitely not like super warm either for Texas. And I'm born and raised in Texas, so even a little bit's cold to me. William, you're fired up. Let her warm up for a second while I throw these gloves on. So, like I said, a mic test, because this bike is kind of loud. I got the, it's a 2016 Fat Boy with the big radius Vance & Hines exhaust, so it's a little noisy. This mic is supposed to be pretty decent. It's the, I think it's a purple something mic. It's got good reviews online, and some other vloggers use it. Basically, my setup is just like John Maxwell. I don't know if anybody's ever seen him, but almost identical to his. I watch him quite a bit. He's pretty cool and very knowledgeable. Other notable YouTubers that I've watched are Sean Smoke as well. He's pretty popular. And there's a bunch out there. Blockhead. But, I got into it because I watched Sean Smoke. And he has topics that he covers, but a lot of his is just driving through the area he lives. And, you know, I saw that and I was like, man, that area he lives in is really nice. And, you know, the area I live in is not like, you know, Alaska or something where it's beautiful scenery, but it's like nice, you know. Well, you'll see it in a minute. This video is also for GoPro placement, seeing which angle is best, because it is kind of a weird thing. I haven't used it yet on this bike, and hopefully you can hear everything I'm saying, because the mic is down near the bottom of my chin on the left side, so it's kind of in a weird spot. I don't know. I'm hoping it doesn't pick up too much wind, but we'll see how it goes. I'll tell you what, it's just nice to get out of the house on the bike, because it's been so freaking rainy and nasty and everything lately. I went for like a 15 second ride the other day, and it was amazing. And it wasn't even, you know, it just made me wanting more, but it was still a good time. Yeah, so this is a 2016 Harley Fat Boy S. Had it for probably 6 months, maybe. Before that, I had a Sportster 48. Freaking cool bike, man, but so small. I'm kind of a bigger guy. That bike is so small. And the tank is the peanut tank. It was a 20. That was a 2016 as well. I think it's a 2016, or I don't know. It was a Harley 48, but I think the tank on that's like 2.4 gallons or something. I don't know. It's something really tiny. And literally, I could ride. I could leave my house, this neighborhood, and I could ride up the road, and you know, go for a decent little rip, and I'd come back and I'd have to put gas in it. Or if I went to, so I live decently close to the Oklahoma border. It's not far. I could literally drive up to Oklahoma, and then I would be out of gas and have to put gas in to come back. So I went on a ride with a buddy a year ago when I had the bike, and we went up to Oklahoma, and yeah, I literally had to put gas in it during our ride. You know, he was riding a Honda VTX or Yamaha V-Star or something, so he had a, you know, a good size tank. It was a full cruiser, and he was like having to wait on me to put gas in, and I was like, you know what, this bike is just not for cruising around a neighborhood or cruising around, you know, a decent small area, or just through town, you know, it's perfect. It's perfect for just cruising around town, but you try and get out on the road with it, yeah, you're not gonna go very far before you need gas. So this bike, I think, has a 4-gallon tank, maybe 4.5, I don't know, but it does pretty good with the gas mileage and everything, and I don't have to fill it up too much. Now, you know, if I went on a big trip, I would, but I haven't had to do it so far. So I can tell you, you know, I've only been riding motorcycles a little while. I started on dirt bikes here and there. Just by no means am I an expert rider, you know. I'd probably put myself in the beginner class still. I feel confident, but I know that I'm not, you know, you got to respect your boundaries too. But I did learn quick. Good gear is really important, and especially gloves. I found gloves, man. I started off wearing these Joe Rocket Amazon gloves. Perfect for summer. I mean, perfect for summer. They're breathable, you know, no worries during the summertime. Perfect for summer. But I got to winter, not even winter, just like a cold snap. And it got down to like 55, 45, you know, and it was like miserable with those gloves on. And yeah, you know, there was times I toughed it out because I wanted to ride, you know, but by no means was it a good time the whole time because my hands are freezing. So finally I was like, you know what, I'm gonna get some good gloves, and I picked up some Harley Davidson gloves, and they got a real good liner in them, man. My hands would be freezing right now, but they are comfortable right now. This is good stuff. You have to have some good gloves for sure. Obviously a decent jacket. I'm not wearing anything heavy. This is just a Harley jacket I picked up at Harley. And it's kind of like a, I don't want to say fleece line. It's just got a good heavy liner in it. And it makes a huge difference as well. Just keeping you warm when you're riding. So I'd say for anybody out there that's just got a motorcycle, you know, your first thing you want to do, obviously, is you're gonna want to start adding a bunch of stuff to your bike and changing things and like doing all this stuff. But I would really encourage you to get some good gear first. And it doesn't have to be anything fancy. I'm not wearing like fancy Harley boots. I think I'm just wearing Vans. So, you know, people would say, oh, you need better footwear, it's dangerous. I get that, and they're right, you know. I just haven't invested the money and just haven't done it. You know, that's my flaw right there. And my pants aren't fancy. I just have some nice gloves and a nice warm jacket on, and obviously I'm wearing a full face helmet. I've tossed around the idea of switching to a half helmet, but with the full face, you got the wind out of your eyes, which I don't have a windshield, obviously. And I have the mounts for it, and I have a windshield for the bike, but it fits weird to me. I get a lot of buffeting when I put it on, so I'm gonna have to look at that. Like I said, I'm a beginner to this. I haven't ridden for a long time or nothing like that. So I had the buffeting. I didn't have a different helmet, so I said I'm taking the windshield off because the wind's not bad. You know, it's not like the end of the world without the windshield on it, because I'm wearing a full face helmet too. So when I first started out doing this, you know, I said I don't want to spend a ton of money. I'm just gonna get a decent little mount for my bike. So I got a little RAM mount, and I can hold my phone on it and stuff, and it works. And I decided one day I'm gonna take a video. I'm not gonna talk in it. I'm just gonna ride, and I'm gonna video it and just see how my phone does. Yeah, waste of time. Absolute waste of time. I started at a gas station, start my bike up, and right away, just violent shaking on the camera. You know, and obviously, I wasn't expecting a lot, but I thought I could at least get, you know, I forget how you know, the vibrations of a Harley are, you know, they're real mean, the vibrations. And I, you know, you don't really feel it in your hands that much. People say you do. Like, I've ridden dirt bikes and stuff, but I guess I've never ridden a luxury bike, so maybe if I did that, I would feel it. But honestly, this, I don't really notice it that much. Now, my camera on my phone did, because the whole video was just shaking in wind until I pulled over, and I was like, oh, that's a nice picture, you know. From really the beginning when I started the bike to the end was all vibrations until I stopped moving, and then it was a decent picture. And you got me leaving the gas station, you got me stopped on the side of the road turning off the camera, and the rest of the video was complete waste. But it ended up, you know what, it ended up being beneficial because that was the first video I ever edited. Just practicing my editing. That was the first video I ever edited. And it, you know, it turned out okay. I threw some music over it and you got a nice vibrate-y picture with nice music. And that was how it turned out. So hopefully this GoPro is a lot better. If you can't tell already, there's really no point to this video. I'm gonna try and start getting into specialty topics, but to be truthful with you, I really just wanted to get out and ride and try out this camera. So I really did not plan this vlog at all. I literally woke up and was like, I'm gonna go for a ride and I'm gonna vlog it, so screw it. So that's what I did. That's what we're doing right now. So that is new. I don't know what that is, man. Maybe they just tore down all the trees around it. I haven't seen that before. But this is one of my favorite rides. It's kind of a loop near my house. It's nothing, you know, there's some cool places I can go up here, and I plan on doing that on this channel. I guess I could make this, turn this video into how this channel is gonna be, I guess. So basically, I live in North Texas. I live near the Oklahoma border, and I plan on just basically taking y'all for rides with me wherever I decide to go. Maybe Oklahoma one day, maybe just around the block, it may, you know. And I'm gonna try and touch on topics. I know in this video I've kind of covered like 18,000, but like I said, I just wanted to get out and ride and didn't really have an itinerary in mind. So yeah, I'm gonna try and just take y'all with me wherever I go, this channel's really for the viewer who just likes scenery, and I'm gonna try and get some better scenery than just this. But you know, I start thinking, you know, if you live in a city where you're a decent distance away from any kind of country, it might be nice to see a video. Just, I know me personally, when I watch John Maxwell, usually I'm looking for tips and information. When I watch Sean Smoke, I just want to turn on a video and just watch it. You know what I mean? I not even have to concentrate on the video, but just look at where he's at and what he's doing and just see the scenery of where he's at. I've always really liked Washington State. And I think he's out near Toledo or something. Always liked that place. I've always liked Washington State as a state. Been there when I was a kid. It's a really cool place. Just beautiful scenery. Look at those dogs over there. They got like a kennel and it's all huskies in the middle of North Texas. So random, but hey, whatever. We'll have to see if my dog's out here today. There's a dog up here on a, it's like a sheep farm or just some people that have sheep. And there's a dog that stays up here. Man, he's a big old fluffy boy. He'll just chase me up the fence. So hopefully he's out here and you guys can take a look at him. This is one of the cooler houses I've seen up here. Just perfect right here in the middle. Just like all land over here, all land back there, and then just a house. And it's not a huge, you know, it's not a huge homestead or nothing, but it's just perfect. So he should be right up here around this corner. Let's see if he's here. Oh, dang, he's not here. Oh, I see the sheep up there by the barn. Sometimes they're down by the fence and he's always with them. He's their little shepherd. And he's some kind of big white fluffy dog. I don't even know, but he's feisty, I'll tell you that. One of my favorite roads up this way to ride, just because it's, I don't think too long ago it was a, not too long ago, I think it was a gravel road. Now it's been paved over, but you still have that kind of treed in area. You can just kind of ride through the trees. It's got decent curve to it, but I really enjoy riding this road, especially for the dog that's out there. He runs up and down the fence and I go by. It's kind of funny. But also just because of the landscape that's around this road. It's not a super long road. Matter of fact, we're gonna reach the end not too long from now, but it's just kind of cool to see all the livestock and See all the different houses that they've built and are building. Here's one of our curves. I'd like to do some ape hangers too to kind of straighten my back up, because I kind of have this natural tendency to be lazy and kind of slump down. And almost, I want to be able to sit up more, and I think if I get some ape hangers that are, you know, kind of around a little bit higher than mirror height, I'm thinking maybe 12s, 10s, probably about right here, I can lean back a little bit more and get my center of gravity and my torso up a little higher and straighten out my spine. Because with the seat I have, you know, my back doesn't really hurt. It's a Mustang Tripper seat that I added to this bike. You know, my back doesn't really hurt that bad or nothing. It's just, after a while, it gets kind of stiffened up on a long ride. And even like the ride we just did, I could keep going, you know. If it wasn't for time, I could keep going. But I just would like to get some higher bars for the added comfort for longer trips, you know. But I'm going to try and do that this summer. I'm going to try and do it myself. We'll see how that goes. I already know, I'm pretty confident that I'm going to go with Hill Country Customs. They're here in Texas, and they already pretty much have them pre-wired. You just put them all together, more or less. So that's what I'm going to try and do. We'll see how that works out. I've seen videos of it being done, and just, you know, if you have a few tools and a basic working knowledge of how to not screw shit up, you know, you can kind of get it, you can kind of do it. But I'll probably try and take a video of before and after that stuff. We'll see how it goes. But let me check in with the old Gestapo here. There's been a few times that I've had to pull up there and try and dig for my card, because they don't want me getting in. I'm a hoodlum. Take the long way home. There's actually quite a few people in this community that ride motorcycles. I think they're all pretty much older, but I really haven't met a single one of them. I've just kind of waved at them as I went by. But I wouldn't mind getting together with somebody up here to ride. It's all right, you can keep going. Oh, they're turning, okay. Man, this is nice just to get out of the house and ride this thing. I'll tell you, I was just sitting there staring at it like a sad kid with a new toy that he can't play with yet. Because, I've had the bike for 6 months or whatever, but it's still, every day that I can ride it, man, I'm on it. I do my best. There's the old spillway for the lake. Not moving too well. Just barely creeping along. I don't even know. Another part of this video is just seeing how this camera does. It's the Hero 7. So, seeing how this camera does with the scenery, and I don't even know if you can see the spillway at all. Hopefully you can. There's a little creek that runs behind it. We're gonna go up here on the damn road. See if you can see the lake. There she is. Definitely not as full as I've seen it, but it's probably a little bit over full. I don't know. I mean, the spillway is moving a little bit, so it's probably over full, and they're draining it out. So, yep, not a bad area, not at all. It's a lot better on a sunny day. But take what we can get when we can get it. Come down here, through here. Take the old Harley off-roading. Sorta. It's more of a, come on, old gal, let's get it. There we go. you guys got any good editing software that you use, comment below. I'm sure I'm probably gonna get like 3 viewers on this first video, if that. But for you 3 people that end up seeing this video, since it is the first video on a channel that has like maybe a total of 6 people subscribed to me, and I don't even know what those people are doing because I've never posted a video on this channel. If you have any good editing software that you know of, go ahead and throw it in the comments section. Preferably free, because this is a hobby. But if it is a cheap software, then let me know, because I'm definitely looking for one. And maybe if one day I'm some kind of big YouTuber like John Maxwell or Sean Smoke, I'll invest in a decent editing software. But for the time being, I'm looking to just, I want to make quality videos, but at the same time, I'm not making a Hollywood film either. And I tell you, Sean Smoke and John Maxwell's videos turn out really well. And hopefully the camera plays a big part of that, because I think Maxwell has the 7 or 8. I know Sean Smoke had the 7, and I think he has the 8 now, and I think they still use both. So their videos seem to turn out really well. And I'm not shooting in 4K because I want the auto stabilization. And from what I've seen and read and stuff, I don't think you have the auto stabilization in 4K. So I think this is like 2.3 or something that I'm shooting in right now. But we'll see how it turns out. And hopefully I didn't ramble too much. That's a new house right there, that blue one. It's kind of a weird color, but it's nice looking because it's brand new. Wouldn't it be a shame if I did all this riding and this camera wasn't even on? Pretty sure I turned it on, but it'd just be terrible. It'd be fun for me, but it wouldn't be very fun for y'all. Change gears there if you want to go somewhere. Yeah, switch into the right gear if you want to go. That big old pothole that's there. It's a bruiser. Quick walk around with the bike. Harley Fatboy S 2016. Like I said earlier, it's got the Vance & Hines big radius, sweatback exhaust, Screaming Eagle package, which is standard on the S, with a 110 motor. I put a Mustang Tripper seat on it, and also put a backrest on it for passenger. A couple things I'd like to change are the handlebars. I'd like to go to Apes probably this summer, and also I'd like to get one of those lay flat license plate brackets to drop that license plate down, because I think it looks funny just kind of sticking up there. I'd like to do some saddlebags too, but I don't know, have to mess with that and see. All right, man. Well, y'all have a good day, and I'll try and get another video in later.